Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.3 Developer Beta 2. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers, or it could be out by the time you're watching this. It came in at 346.7 megabytes for me on my iPhone XR, and it can vary depending on which device you're on. Let's take a look at the build number. The build is 16F5129D, and this particular build does not really do a whole lot, so if you're looking for a lot of features, we really won't see any until iOS 13. In June when they show that for the first time, and then it's released in September. But as far as what they've added to this one, well, only really one thing, and that has to do with the Japanese calendar. So they're entering a new Japanese calendar or a Japanese era, and it's added support for, I'm going to not say this properly probably, but it's Dewa. And that's the new era of the Japanese calendar. So they're going to enter that, or it looks like it's pronounced Raiwa in English, but hopefully I got that name not too messed up. But it begins on May 1st and is available in this beta. And that means maybe this beta will come out before May 1st in the full form of 12.3 because they need to get that Japanese calendar support out there, or maybe the release in a smaller update. It's hard to say. However, if you want to play around with the calendar and make sure it's working for you, if you do that, Apple says you might experience unexpected behavior when it comes to changing the system time. So just be aware of that. Now, as far as anything else new, there isn't a whole lot new other than a new modem number and a new carrier number. So hopefully that fixes the issues with LTE and Wi-Fi. I had a few issues, mostly with loading images in different apps, such as Twitter. So sometimes they wouldn't load. I would have to turn on airplane mode, turn it back off, and then it would work. I'm not sure what's going on this time around, but to me, it seems more and more like it's a hardware issue because of those Intel modems. It's hard to say for sure. I'd love to talk to an Apple engineer about it just out of curiosity, but it seems like there's something going on and occasionally it just doesn't connect. So it may be resolved this time. It's hard to say. Only a few days will show us that for sure. Now, as far as battery life on this particular update, it's hard to say what that's going to be like because it's only been out for a couple hours at this point. So battery on this device, my XS Max here, and you'll see I have a case on it. It's an Apple case and a screen protector, which I never use. I'll talk about that in another video, but we'll go into settings. We'll go to battery, and the battery health on this is 100% on this phone as well. And the last 10 days here, you'll see, well, if I go to this day, 4 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 9 hours and 13 minutes of screen off time. That's mostly because of email apps. There isn't a whole lot else using battery. The Tesla app's using 4%, and I've been changing email apps and trying different ones, so they're using a little bit more power. But overall, that's with about 20 to 30% battery life left at the end of the day, so battery life is okay. It's not great, but it's okay. Now, as far as anything else in this particular beta? Well, there's really only one other thing as far as a bug, and that has to do with deleting apps. And let me see if I can find it. The extras that I have here, the Apple native apps, if you delete these, they could cause instability or problems in the settings app. Right now, settings isn't locking up, but maybe that's part of the cause. It's hard to say right now. Now, they have resolved an issue as well, which is always a good thing, and that has to do with the iPad. Now, not this particular iPad. This is the 10.5-inch iPad Pro, but it does resolve palm rejection on the 11-inch third-generation iPad. So if you were on the beta and the palm rejection wasn't working, well, it should be working now. And really, this particular update, 12.3, is all about this TV app, and that's really what we're waiting for, is this TV app and Apple TV to have this app as well. And that's the other thing they updated today, was Apple TV and Apple Watch. So there's new betas for that, and that is really it. There's nothing new going on with any of this stuff, unfortunately. But there is a neat little feature that was pointed out, and it has to do with AirPods. Now, it doesn't just work on the betas. It works on 12.2 as well. But if you have the old AirPods and the new ones, and you swap them out and mismatch these, so I'll put the first version in here, close it, open it back up. It says mismatched AirPods. And so it will tell you which one is which. So it will tell you which one's mismatched. It's kind of a neat feature that quite a few people missed, and I thought was kind of helpful. So I'll set those aside, and it's opening on all of these. Now let's talk about speed. So far, speed is pretty good. I haven't had any issues, but again, it's only been out a couple hours at this point. not even 2 hours really. And it seems to be okay. Scrolling speed is fine. I haven't had settings lock up. You'll see it did stop for a second before it was responsive, but I haven't had any 10 second lockups or anything, and it seems to be fine. A good way to measure that is on an older device like the 6S Plus that I have here. If we go here, rotate to landscape, and then 3D touch, if that doesn't lag, chances are the OS is going to be fairly smooth overall. But I did do a Geekbench on this device and my iPhone XS Max. So let's take a look at that. Now on the iPhone 6S Plus, which will of course be lower since it's a little bit older, we have 2,562 for single core and 4,424 for multi-core. When it comes to the XS Max, it's a lot higher at 4,838 for single core, 11,017 for multi-core. Now if we look at the history of that, it's quite good. I ran this twice today here, and then this is the previous version. So it's, as long as it's above 11,000, that's kind of what we're looking for in the high 4,000s and 11,000. As long as it's in there, it seems like everything's working okay. One thing to note though, is right after I updated these, both the XS Max and the XR were quite warm. So there was definitely a lot of background activity going on. So those scores could improve even a little bit more. Now I'd love to show you how iOS 12.3 beta 1 or beta 2 is on the iPhone 5S, but I can't unfortunately, because this battery is pretty much done. So I do have a video about that, and I do have a new battery for it as well. So maybe I'll change that on video. Let me know what you think about that. And that's really it for this particular update. I haven't found anything new. I've checked all the settings, control center, and all of those different places, and I haven't found anything at all. That's it for iOS 12.3 beta 2. And there's not much more to talk about, but let me know what you think about it in the comments below. And if you're still watching this at this point, I was going to film this outside, but unfortunately I went outside to drive to where I was going to film it and it started raining. So maybe next time, but let me know if you like the indoor or the outdoor setting better. Love to hear what you have to say about that. I do enjoy filming outside since it's a little bit different. But of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe and like if you enjoyed the video. If not, the other one's okay too. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.